Safety is an important concern when working with the electrical systems of hybrid vehicles, particularly when removing and installing hybrid vehicle batteries. Because of the high voltage that the batteries generate, removing and installing hybrid batteries is an inherently dangerous activity and can lead to serious or even fatal injuries. Suitable training is essential before removing, installing, or servicing this product, which should only be attempted by a qualified technician. Please attentively watch this video and read the technical specification sheets, warnings, instructions, and safety measures that accompany the product. Using the proper techniques and safety measures for removing, installing, or servicing hybrid vehicles' batteries are your sole responsibility. You personally assume all risks and responsibilities for any damage, injury, or death that result from your misuse of our products or from your failure to use the proper safety equipment or take the proper safety measures. If you are not a qualified technician, do not attempt to remove, install, or service hybrid vehicle batteries. To complete this installation, you will need the following tools: deep sockets in 10mm, 12mm, and 14mm, a trim removal tool, a ratchet or impact wrench with a 6-inch extension, a Cat 3 1000-volt rated voltmeter and leads, and high-voltage gloves with leather protectors that are Class 0 1000-volt rated. And remember, when working with high-voltage hybrid vehicle systems, always wear insulating gloves until instructed to remove them. To begin, turn off the ignition and slide both front seats to their forwardmost position. Remove the 12-volt battery negative cable. Put on high-voltage safety gloves to access the orange high-voltage disconnect located in the right front of the trunk, behind the cutout in the trim panel. Lift up on the handle while pulling outward and remove it from the vehicle. Store it in a secure area away from the vehicle. Next, remove all trunk trim surrounding the battery pack and battery cooling fan, as well as the trunk floor covering. Fold down both rear seat backs. Using a trim removal tool, remove all trim on the passenger side of the battery pack and fan. Remove the remaining ductwork, which are secured by push clips. Remove the wiring plug from the battery cooling fan. Remove the bolts securing the cooling fan to the battery. Remove the ductwork from the side of the battery cooling fan. The battery cooling fan can now be removed by sliding it out towards the passenger side. Remove the remaining ductwork from the side of the trunk. Remove the wiring harness clamps from the battery cover. Using a 10mm socket, remove the bolts securing the electronics cover to the seat side of the battery pack. Using the orange safety disconnect handle as a tool, release the orange retainer clip on the electronics cover. Put on your high-voltage safety gloves. Remove the cover from the right side of the battery. Remove the wire terminal cover from the single black wire on the right end of the battery. Note that although this wire is black, it is the 12-volt positive battery terminal connected directly to the 12-volt battery and is live constantly. Do not mistakenly connect it to ground. Remove the wire harness plug from the right end of the battery and then check for voltage across both orange cables. If the voltage is below 30 volts, it is safe to work without your high-voltage safety gloves. Remove and retain the two nuts securing the orange cables to the battery. Remove the battery vent hose. Using a 12mm socket, remove 6 bolts securing the battery to the floor. place cardboard on the trunk floor. With the help of an assistant, slide the battery to the rear of the trunk and remove it from the vehicle. Simply reverse this procedure to reinstall, paying close attention to the installation of the safety disconnect. Make sure the handle is pushed in a downward direction until it clicks after folding the handle up. Once the installation is complete, please use the following procedures when packing the original battery core for return shipment and credit. The battery core must be intact and returned in the shipping container provided with the replacement battery. The core must be the same part type and application as the purchased replacement unit. Do not write on the shipping container. And finally, contact the place of purchase for core credit and shipping instructions. For technical support, visit www.dormanproducts.com or call 866-933-2911. This video is for general information purposes only. Dorman Products Incorporated makes no representations or warranties, oral or written, express or implied, regarding the information contained in this video. You are responsible for consulting and complying with all state and federal laws. Please consult with an ASE-certified automotive professional before any automotive repairs. The entire risk as to the results and the performance of the information contained in this video is assumed by the viewer, and in no event shall Dorman Products Incorporated or its customers be liable for any consequential, incidental, special, or direct damages suffered in the course of using the information in this video.